Hello and welcome to the TechyV.com, your solution provider. I'm Frank, here to talk about TeamViewer 7, a program to connect your PCs for remote control, file transfer, live meeting, presentations and more. Besides having most common features like other remote access programs, it has a special feature, no installation, which allows running the program temporarily without installation so that you can give quick tech support. It also allows you to reboot and reconnect to computers. You can also access to PCs using your web browser. And for viewing, TeamViewer automatically optimizes display quality according to your internet speed. And for all this, TeamViewer is unique. Installing and configuring TeamViewer 7 is very easy. Launch the EXE installer and self-extraction will run in background. Welcome to the installation wizard. As I've said, TeamViewer can be used just to get connected from any remote PC without installation, so you don't need any administrative privileges for that. And if you install it, then you can have complete access, which I'll show you now. It should be selected as install and click in this box, show advanced settings to check every settings. Click next to continue. You'll be asked to set usage purpose. Click to select your option and click next. Now click these boxes to check and agree with the license agreement and then click next. Now if you select yes here, then you can access this PC later by setting up a predefined password. Otherwise if you select no, then you need to run TeamViewer manually and a username and a password will be generated from server randomly, which you'll need to access this PC. Well, I'm selecting yes. Now set the accessibility. I suggest to keep this option full access, because if you select confirm all, then every actions to be performed for remote control will be asked for permission from this PC, but this can be bothering, so leave it like that. Then click next. You can create a VPN, that is virtual private network, with TeamViewer. Click to check this box to select it, but TeamViewer VPN needs to be installed in other computers as well. Then click next. To change the default install location, click browse and browse the directory and click next to continue. This will be the start menu shortcut. Click finish and installation process will begin. TeamViewer will run immediately after install completes. Mainly you access remote computers by two ways: by LAN connection, requires no internet, or by internet using any connection type. Now if you want to set a predefined password and a username, then you need to register an account to TeamViewer server. By this you can also access this PC from a web browser. I'm skipping this now, just showing you how to connect for control and file transfer, but you can configure it later by launching the connection menu and then select setup unattended access. To connect via LAN connection, you need to configure the LAN settings. Launch the extras menu and select options. Display name will be set according to your computer name, which you can change in your choice. Just change the incoming LAN connections to accept. Click security to set your own password. Type a password here and then retype it here. Then click OK to exit. This is the generated ID and password from server. You need it to access this remote PC. But if you are out of internet, then the IP address will be displayed here instead of a server ID. Or you can check it manually from the LAN properties. Now just type the PC's IP address or server ID and click connect to take control, or select file transfer to launch the file transfer window. Now enter the password. Okay, your client's desktop will launch in a new window. You can view it in full screen by clicking on the view menu, then mouse over to scaling, then click full screen. You can perform any actions from here. For file transfer, you can simply drag and drop files like this. Or you can do through its file manager, click file transfer menu and click file transfer again. You can browse files from here. On the left side shows local computer, that is your computer, and on the right side shows remote computer. Just browse your files or folders and drag and drop from one side to another side, and a status dialog will be displayed in both client and local computer. You can also chat with the client by clicking on the audio video menu, then select chat. Type your message here and press enter. For voice chatting, click this icon to transmit voice and click transmit my audio. Similarly, click this icon and click transmit my video for video chat. Your client needs to transmit as well for both side communications. You can use this software for free non-commercial use, like just to help your neighbor computers in your apartment. And if you use it for business purpose, then the price starts from $749. You can check out more related articles in the TechyV.com. So thanks for watching this.